Hi, this is Caroleeena. I've been sick for a week with the flu and I'm wanting to do something creative, so I'm gonna try to make a video. And plus Mulder needs to come outside too because he's been in for a whole week because I've been in for a whole week. So I wanna do a video on a move I call a tuck toss. It's based on a poi move called the tuck, where you can do a turn. So you tuck the poi under your arm and you turn all the way around 180 to the other side. Show you that from the front. Tuck it under your arm. All the way around. Based on this move, there are several variations of tucks that you can do. You can do a contact tuck where you place it under your arm and just let it roll over. You can do a tuck toss where you toss it up high or where you toss it to the front and you can catch it with either hand. And you can even do a tuck turn toss where you're facing one way. You catch it the other way. I don't completely have that perfectly yet, but it's going to be fabulous when I finally get it. So I'm going to introduce all of those, and it all starts with the tuck. So with a hoop, if your hoop is outside, your side hand hooping, and your fingers are pointing at a 90 degree angle from your body, your thumb is up, it's like you're shaking hands with somebody to the side, but you're looking at somebody else. You want to wait till the hoop comes over to the top, is falling down and is about to go across the bottom of the palm. When it hits the bottom of the palm, you close your fingers on it, do just the tiniest bit of an isolation as you stretch your elbow out, and then bend at the elbow so that your back of your hand comes up under your arm. Your finger, index finger, is almost pointed down, and look how my elbow's at a 90 degree angle. And from here, you can let go in a variety of ways. If your hand is good and close to under your arm, not out here, get it close, you can just fall forward from the heart and let it roll over. Sorry, you icky. I'm sorry, man. So, practice that first, and I find that that's where most people have trouble with this movement.
So here's what I want you to picture.
You know how people who lead marching bands, look at the cat, they use one of these kind of things? Well, they do a turn where they tuck it under their arm. That's what I want you to practice. I want you to practice holding the stick up like this, making the top of the stick go down and under so that the back of your knuckles come up all the way in your arm. And you can look out and see if that is level. So if it's pointed down like this or up like this or it's down here, then you know you don't have it where you want to release it. So if we release the staff in this position while falling forward, it would naturally fall over our arm. The projection of it is that it would go. And that's what we want our hoop to do, so we have to have our hand all the way up here. So the first thing to practice is just doing the tuck, where you grab your hoop, pull it out, tuck it under your arm. From the sides, your hoop is going forward, you wait till it's coming down from the top, you grab it, tuck it under your arm. Once you start to get this tuck, then you can practice bending at the heart. So it's just like the drop, the fall that we do for the cross the back roll. We let our heart lead the way down and toward a 90 degree angle. And then we let the hoop go. So if we let it go here, it's going to just roll around our shoulder. And all we have to do at that point is keeping our thumb up, reach out, and grab it. You can grab it from either side. I recommend grabbing it from the outside, though later you're going to practice grabbing it with the other hand. So, practice that. See if you can get into that rhythm. Practice catching it with the right hand from the outside. And practice catching it from the left hand from the inside. With either hand, but I recommend at first practicing from the outside. Watch. Every side. So, once you get this tuck, if you are doing this with a poi, it would be like tucking, turning, and following it. So practice tucking it under your arm and then turning and following it. It takes you into a barrel roll. So once you've got your tuck toss, you can practice doing it forward. The further you drop from your heart, the further forward it's going to go. But you can also practice doing it straight upright so that you don't let go until you are not just under the pit, but behind it about a quarter of the turn of your arm. So if you can let it go here so that its trajectory is straight up, it'll come up and you can catch it. The thing about tuck tosses is you just got to practice them until you get the feel for where they're going to land. So the other cool thing that you can do with a tuck toss is you can do a tuck toss with a 180 degree turn. Catch it on the opposite hand, facing the opposite direction. The hoop is still going the same direction it's going, but while I'm facing this way, it's going forward. When I'm facing that way, in orientation to me, it's going backwards. So I'm going to do a tuck toss, and I'm going to try to release it so that it goes in a circle like this, so that it would automatically be heading back down. But try to wait till it's at its highest point or close to it, and I'm going to turn all the way around up here, hopefully like this. So the trick is to let it go, and you got to practice on your toss at first to make it. It's kind of going behind you, but it's going behind you in a circle, so that it's just going to keep coming right back. Tuck turns are too hard to explain, and I hope you can work with that.